All right, the first thing I want to do in this lecture is to review the concept of a derivative. The derivative is the basis of calculus, so it's very important to understand the concept of a derivative, otherwise nothing's going to make sense in this class. So what is a derivative? If we have a relationship where y is a function of x, then the derivative tells us how the value of the function changes as we change that variable x. Okay, so for example, if we have a relationship where distance is a function of time, then the derivative of that function tells us how distance changes as we change the time, as ch time changes. And so that's the velocity. So for example, if the distance was given in miles and the time is in hours, then the derivative, the units of the derivative, would be in miles per hour. So in general, we can estimate the derivative of a function at a point by computing the average rate of change over smaller and smaller intervals around that point. And then using that idea, we can actually come up with a formula for the derivative, right? So at an arbitrary point x, we can look at the average rate of change between x and x plus h, and then let h gets smaller and smaller because essentially h is the interval width. And this average rate of change is essentially slope. It's just the change in the function over the change in x, right? So it's just delta y over delta x, right? This is essentially delta y, and this is just delta x, right? So delta x is h. It's rise over run, which is just slope. Okay, so the derivative of a function is essentially an instantaneous slope. It's the instantaneous rate of change of a function. And we define the derivative to be the limit as h goes to zero of this average rate of change. All right, so it's important to understand the derivative as instantaneous rate of change or the slope of the function at any point. So if the rate of change of the function is positive, that means that the slope is positive, right? If the derivative is positive, the slope is positive, and it means that the function is increasing, right? We have a positive rise for a positive run. If the derivative is negative on an interval, then that means the function is decreasing, okay, right? That means the slope is decreasing. The slope is negative, so the function is decreasing, meaning we have a negative rise, right? A negative rise would be going down, right? For a positive run. Okay? So we can tell whether from just the sign of the derivative, we can tell whether the function is increasing or decreasing. If the derivative is positive, the function is increasing. If its derivative is negative, then it's decreasing, right? Because it's just slope. Now, if we take the derivative of the derivative, then we get the second derivative, and the second derivative tells us about the curvature of the function. All right. And so if you remember from Math 108, if the derivative is po the second derivative is positive, right, that means that the slope is increasing and you end up with a curve that is concave up. So it's concave up, meaning that it's shaped like a U. That's how I remember concave up, right? It's shaped like a U. And if the second derivative is negative, that means that the rate of change, the slope, is decreasing, and so it's concave down. So the shape is a upside down U. Okay. So we have these four different variations of combinations of the rate of change and the concavity. So we can have a curve that's concave up and decreasing, concave up and increasing, or we could have it could be concave down and increasing, or concave down and decreasing. So we have these different shapes. So, all right, let's get to example one, all right, after 4 minutes here. So let's take a look at this example. Now, you've probably seen some problems like this before. We're given the graph of a function and we're asked to graph its derivative. Okay, so just remember that the derivative is just slope. So we can look at the slope. And in this first one, we just have lines. So it's actually pretty easy to look at the slope of the function. So we can look at rise over run. If we look at a couple of points on this function, then we go down by 2 and over by 1, which means we have a slope of what is that? Negative 2, right? So that means the derivative is negative 2. So we can come down here to this graph and really anywhere on this portion where x is less than 0, for x less than 0, the slope is going to be negative 2. It doesn't matter what 2 points I take. I get a slope of negative 2, right? As long as x is less than 0, then it changes. So when x is less than 0, we have a slope of a negative 2. So the derivative is just going to be negative 2 until we get to 0, right? And I don't know, actually, let me draw that a little bit differently because I think I need to put an open circle because at this point at 0, the derivative really isn't defined. It's not negative 2, and it's not positive 2, right? Because that's the derivative on for x greater than 0. You can see we have a rise of 2 for a run of 1, and so the derivative is going to be positive 2, right? Anywhere, any 2 points that we choose on this portion of the graph of f of x, where x is greater than 0, then the slope of the function is positive 2. Okay, so that's what the derivative, this is f prime of x, that's what the derivative of this function, it looks like an absolute value function shifted down by 3. So that's what the derivative would look like. Okay, so for that one, we can actually find the actual value of the derivative. In general, when we're trying to graph the derivative of a function from, the graph of the function, it's kind of hard to tell, the actual values of the derivative at different points. But we can tell the sign of the derivative because we can look at the curve and tell whether it's increasing or decreasing. And so, for example, if we look at this next curve, we can look at any point over here on where x is less than 1, and you can see that if we draw a tangent line here, it has a positive slope, right? And any point that I take over on this side of the graph, even up here, it's a little bit shallower, but you can see that the slope of the function is positive. Okay, and then we get to a point here. So f, here I'll just write f prime is greater than 0. So f prime is 0. The derivative is positive, okay, because the function is increasing. All right, until you get to this point here at x equals 1, right, and then it's changing direction, right? You can see over here on this portion of the graph. If I take any point and I try to draw a tangent line to it, you can see it's decreasing, right? So f prime is less than 0. And at 1, it's sort of in a transition. At 1, if we draw a tangent line, it looks pretty flat. So that's one place where we can tell that the value of the derivative is 0 because the tangent line when x is equal to 1 is 0. So the value of the derivative at 1 is 0. Other than that point, we don't, it's hard to really to put a value on the derivative, except that we know that it's positive, it's increasing, the function itself is increasing, so the derivative is positive to the left of 1, and the value of the derivative to the right of 1 is negative, right? Because the function is decreasing. So I don't know exactly what's happening, but I know it's positive. I don't know the exact values, but I know that the derivative is positive to the left of 1 and it's negative to the right of 1. So that's as good as I can get as far as as far as what the derivative of this function looks like. So that's a pretty decent estimation of what it looks like. It's just going to be positive to the left because it's increasing to the left of 1 and the function is decreasing to the right of 1. So the derivative is going to be positive to the left of 1 and negative to the right of 1. Okay. All right, so let's look at another function here. And what we're going to do is just look at whether the function is increasing or decreasing. And so you can see that if I were to draw a tangent line on any portion of this curve to the left of zero, it's always decreasing, all right? So the value of the function is negative, all right? The value of the derivative is negative. All right, now the value of the function is negative too, but the value of the derivative is negative because on this portion of the curve, it's decreasing, right? But you can see that as x gets bigger and bigger in this direction here, it looks like it's becoming more and more shallow, right? It's becoming more and more flat, whereas down here, it's very, very steep. It's a very, very high number. Okay, so if I were to draw this, I want to draw it so that, you know, over here it's close to zero, and then it's steeper as we approach zero, right? Steeper and steeper, but in the negative direction, right? So the value of the function is negative. So I'm this is f prime of x, and the value of the derivative is negative because the function is decreasing. And as we approach, as x approaches negative infinity, it's approaching zero, right? Because these tangent lines are flatter and flatter, right? So, and then as x approaches zero, the function is getting steeper and steeper in the negative direction, all right? So, so that might be a good estimation of what the derivative looks like. So let's look at the other half of this curve, right? We have an asymptote at zero. And now if I look at any tangent lines on this portion of the graph, you can see they're still decreasing, right? But now they're getting shallower and shallower as x approaches infinity, right? Here we had x approaching, well, maybe I could draw it this way, negative infinity, right? And it was becoming closer and closer to zero. But it also looks like it's the value of the derivative is approaching zero as x approaches positive infinity as well, okay? But again, the value of the derivative is negative because the function itself is decreasing, all right? So I'm going to have something similar over here. We're approaching zero, but it's negative, right? So it's over here. And it's getting steeper and steeper, but it's still negative, right? The value is still negative as we approach zero. So it's going to look kind of like this, right? It's kind of symmetric about the y-axis. So that would be an estimation of what the shape of the derivative would look like for the function that's given above it. All right, so that covers, that's just sort of a review of the concept of the derivative. It's very important to think of it as slope. That's the main thing. We're thinking of it, of the derivative of a function as the slope at any point, the instantaneous rate of change, or the slope at of the tangent line at any point. All right. So I will meet you in the next video for the next example.